Hello, humans of 220, and welcome to our brain break. As you have realized, our classroom changes quite regularly, whether we're in the same building, the same room, or in our respective homes, taking care of ourselves, helping out with our brothers and sisters, playing with our animals, learning from home. Every week, something different is evolving in our classrooms across the city, across the state, and across the country, and in the world in general. So this week's journey is going to take us to a peaceful place of your choice, and we're just going to take a brain break so that we can remember that it's not all about learning, it's not all about play, it's not all about any one particular thing that we are doing or not doing. It's about a balance of everything. So a little bit goes a long way these days. So, as we always start out, find your comfortable spot. It might be the same spot that you settled into last week. It might be a new spot that you've created for yourself, like a fort or a tent or a hideaway that just is your bliss. So find those pillows, the blankets, or stand comfortably up against a wall. Whatever it is that makes your space and your brain break perfect for you. So as you start to settle in, gently close your eyes. Relax your shoulders. And take your first complete inhale. Filling up those lungs. And exhale it out completely. Inhale again, filling up even deeper, and exhale it out. One more deep cleansing breath in, and exhale it out completely, just letting your body settle, feeling the ground beneath you. Whether it's your feet touching the ground, whether it's your body settling in. Doing a body scan from head to toe, just let your mind check in. Starting at the top of your head, how does it feel? Lots of things running through your head. You're not alone. It's okay. Those are all important pieces to what make us who we are. But they don't all have to be addressed right now. In good time, we'll take care of all of those pieces and fit them into our puzzle beautifully. But for now, just let them go. Kind of floating off into the back of your mind. And we'll get to that to-do list later. Work that scan down your throat. Breathing in. And exhaling out. How do your shoulders feel? Are they tucked up next to your ears like earmuffs? According to the calendar, winter's over, friends. Time to put away the earmuffs. Drop those shoulders. Continue that scan down your arms, down your torso, down your legs, and into your feet. Those amazing feet that we take for granted that hold us up every single day. How do these parts feel? Are they a little wonky? Are they a little tight? Maybe we need to move around more. All these little twinges or feelings or lack of feelings are just reminders of what our body needs. Just like when our stomach growls, it says, I'm hungry. And we feed it. So we just want to feed our body what it needs, whether it's a glass of water more often, maybe it's a brain break 4 or 5 times a day. Maybe it's playing, coloring, having a snack, learning to do something you've always wanted to do. Friends, this is our time to settle in and do things for ourselves and our families and the ones we love, both near and far. So, as we take this time for ourselves, take a nice big inhale and sigh it out and settle in. I want you to think of a place that makes you feel like you can conquer any challenge that is put in front of you. I want you to think of that space in your mind that puts a smile on that amazing face every time you think of it. And I want you to know that this space that you're creating is all yours. Each time you need to vacation in your own home, in your own mind, find this comfortable place, find this wonderful spot that you're creating, and settle into it. And just start to feel that peace, that quiet, that happiness that lives within you that sometimes get lost in day-to-day and moment-by-moment events that can derail us, cause us to get off track. Don't be hard on yourself when these moments happen, because they do to everybody. Every human has those moments where they get discouraged or scared or frustrated or angry. But just as quickly we can find moments of happiness and peace and laughter and silliness that remind us that we can and we will get through this together. We didn't need COVID-19 to tell us how strong we are collectively as a classroom, as a family, as a city, as a community, and as a world. We knew that from the day you stepped foot in room 220. This is just a reminder that we've got this, friends. You are not alone, and you will never be alone. So take this time to take gentle care of yourself. Be more patient with yourself, with your family, with your friends, and those loving animals. They are enjoying the attention that they're getting with all their humans in the house at the same time. So take the time to be good to yourself and to do something kind and loving for those around you. Inhale. And exhale completely, letting your body sink in even more into the ground that protects you and holds you. as we visit this beautiful space that you've created. Look around with your eyes closed gently. Do you notice a smile growing on your face because it is the most beautiful place you have ever taken yourself so far on this magical journey of just time and space? As you sit and observe your surroundings, are you noticing something different that if you hadn't slowed down today, you may have missed? Isn't it beautiful how when you're giving time to yourself and others, you notice the small details that you often take for granted? And those small, what we would consider insignificant details in our daily rush of life are actually monumental memories that help us to become who we are in our better and best format. So, as we slow down and we take care of ourselves, we are able to see those small bits and pieces that we've overlooked for so long and realize how truly priceless they are. A gift is being given by the pause that we're taking. A time to recalibrate, and reevaluate, and replenish all the energy that we've often given out, used without even thinking about. Now we can think, and we can pause, and we can laugh and smile and curl up on the couch if we need a break, just like we would in our classroom with all of our wonderful relaxation tools. You have them all at home with you. Find the time. Find your breath. Find your bliss. As we start to come back into our present moment, take a deep inhale and exhale. Start to wiggle your fingers and your toes gently and mindfully. Easily rocking your head from side to center to side to get that blood flowing, to get that movement flowing. We're going to gently work our way up to a seated tall spine. Nice and easy as you sit back up if you are laying down or curled up in a ball. If you are already seated, get comfy. Adjust your seat and how you feel. And just sit for a minute. How do you feel? Check in with yourself. And take one giant inhale with me. And exhale it completely. gently sinking into the ground with your seat, feeling so safe and grounded and protected. As you slowly open your eyes to see the beautiful world around you and the wonderful people that you get to share this journey with. I thank you for sharing some of your time with me today. I hope that you feel more alive, more calm, and much more lighthearted than when you started your morning. I will see you soon. I am here for you. I am with you. And I love you, my friends. Take care and be well.